evening, everyone, and welcome to Training Tuesday for December 8th, 2020. I'm Lori with Behavior Education at Spirit Keeper Equine Sanctuary, and we have several snake learners to show you this evening. Please join us as we guide them through their training sessions. Some of them you'll recognize, and some of them may be new to you. Please make sure that you pay attention to the narration because, as usual, I'm going to guide you through each session so you know exactly what's going on with each learner, and I will tell you just a little bit about each snake. Our first learner is Roberta Lincoln. She is a 1.5-year-old Okeedy corn snake, and she's pretty outgoing. Here I'm targeting her out of her enclosure and onto a temporary holding station or an activity stand. She's doing a great job. She's really concentrating and she's taking her time and she's following that target. But right there, she just couldn't wait any longer and she struck at it and started to wrap the perch, but she re-engages very quickly and starts to follow the target on down. So I set it down and intervened with the food before she had a chance to strike at it again, because striking at it's not something I want to reinforce. Now we're moving on to her clutch mate, a 1.5-year-old male corn snake named Gary Seven. He is less outgoing than her, so I made his session very simple to start out with, just to gauge how he was going to behave this evening. And he actually did very well. Now this is Roberta Lincoln's second repetition during the same session, and we targeted her out of the enclosure for the first repetition, and now I'm going to target her back into her enclosure for her second repetition. She's going a little bit more slowly this direction, and it may be because this is the first time that I have targeted her back into her enclosure. I've targeted her out of her enclosure quite a few times. And then I usually pick her up and put her back in, or I just push the temporary holding bin next to her enclosure and she goes back in on her own. This is the first time I'm actually asking her to shift back in following the target. I get her in just as far as I think that she's gonna tolerate being patient. And when I think that she's reached the end of her attention span, I go ahead and just ask her for a direction change. She gives me that, and then I reinforce her. I was banking on the massive coil that she always gives when she eats to pull the rest of her body back into her enclosure, and it didn't quite make it, so I had to help out a little bit with just the end of her tail, but that didn't bother her at all. She didn't miss a beat. She kept on eating. And I just want to remind everyone, with very tiny snakes, or corn snakes or king snakes, to use sliding tops if you're using a terrarium so that the snakes don't escape. This is Gary Seven's second repetition during the same session. Now this time I've moved the activity station adjacent to his enclosure, and I'm actually going to see how far I can get him to shift out of his enclosure and onto the activity stand. He has never done this before. I wasn't sure how far I was going to be able to stretch him, and he made it to the perch and then struck. I asked him to go a little bit further, which he actually did, and I placed the reinforcer right in front of the target so that instead of striking the target again, the reinforcement was there for him to take. And then I helped him back into his enclosure and made sure that that top was secured. Our next learner in this evening's session is a carpet python, or Morelia spilota. His name is Sahul, and he's 3.5 years old. There he is up on the upper right, up on his shelf, and I'm asking him just to target down off of his shelf. When I first got him as a juvenile, I did not start target training him immediately. It wasn't until he was about 18 months to 2 years old that I started target training, so he got kind of a late start. But he's picked it up very well. He's doing very well. And I really don't have any issues with him at all. This is a 5-month-old Morelia Bredley that was produced by Ralph Polinsky. His name is Shepherd, and I'm just going to ask him to touch the target. So this is pretty simple, but this is only his 5th or 6th session. And so I really want to reinforce that the operant behavior he has to perform to earn reinforcement is touching the target. This is our rough-scaled python, Morelia carinata. His name is Sangral. He is only 6 months old. He also came from Ralph Polinsky. He's an extremely confident and outgoing animal. I'm asking him to target all the way from the uppermost part of his enclosure down to the lower level, across the enclosure threshold and a little bit out the door, and then touch the blue side of the target to earn his reinforcement. And he does this cautiously, but he does it fluidly. He doesn't miss a beat. He is just a wonderful little snake and extremely smart. He's actually asked to come out of his enclosure a couple of times, even though he hasn't been here very long, and explored a little bit around the room. This is our 5-month-old Morelia Bredley Kitesh, and she was also produced by Ralph Polinsky. She's going to keep me on my toes as a trainer. She sees the target, she orients towards the target, and she looks at it and tongue flicks at it, but then she looks off to her left, where she has received reinforcement from in the past. So I move the target to prompt her to re-engage with it. I want her to do more than look at the target and then seek the reinforcement. I want her to understand that the operant behavior she has to perform to earn the reinforcement is actually following the target and touching it, which she finally did and earned her reinforcement. So hopefully she remembers that for next time. This is a 3-year-old albino Darwin carpet python that we got from Nerd, although they did not produce him. He's been with us a few months, and I actually started him targeting with a green target, and I really didn't feel like he was responding too well to that. And when I showed him this blue one, right off the bat, he seemed to respond to it. And so I'm switching over to this blue one. I do have a video that I think's unpublished where I'm switching him from the green to the blue. He's very good at holding in position when he gets to the target, and now I'm trying to get him to understand that the reinforcement's going to be delivered from elsewhere. He didn't exactly understand that, and I went to stick the reinforcement in front of his nose on the target, and when he struck at it, he obviously fell out. But he was fine, and when he was finished eating, he climbed back into his enclosure. Now we're back with Shepherd for his second repetition during the same session, and I'm asking him to actually come over his enclosure threshold this time. And I would like him to make a farther journey. So I'm making him go further to engage with the target this time. He understands when the target stops, he should stop. And so I moved it a little bit just to get him to come out a little further before I delivered the reinforcement. But he's actually just a perfect learner so far. He's just doing great. All right, what video would be complete without our false water cobra, Vashti? Vashti just shed 2 days ago, and so it's been about 10 days since she has eaten, which is quite a long time for a juvenile false water cobra. And she was already coming at the door when I was getting everything ready, and then she literally kind of attacks the target, and I'm trying to show her that the reinforcer is next to the target, and she kind of goes wild here and snatches the food and goes back into her enclosure and takes it under the water to eat it. It's not the first time that she's done this. I wait to make sure she's finished eating and wait for her to calm down a little bit and look in my direction. And as soon as she does that, I prepare to do a second repetition with her. But before I could pick up the target and pick up the tongs with the reinforcer on it, she decided to just come out of her water and launch herself out of her enclosure. She was fine. I picked her up from off the floor, put her back into her enclosure, and set her up with this simple puzzle exercise. It's just a loose blue ball that's the same as the one on the target stick, and I put 3 pinkies in with it. And I left it in the enclosure with her so that she could interact with the ball and eat her food without me present. And that worked great because when I went back later, the ball was still in the deli cup, but all the food was gone. I'm wondering if I should move Vashti back to my desk where she was before, because I think she's learning bad habits from this little corn snake that's living below her. This is Sundust. She's 3 years old. She came from Port City Pet, and she's very enthusiastic about eating. She definitely knows the target means food, and she doesn't want to wait to perform any kind of operant behavior on that target. She just wants her food. But when I insist, she does a really nice job. Here she finally pauses nicely next to the target and waits to receive her reinforcement from off to the side. She's not stupid. She knows that the target means food and that the reinforcement's going to come from somewhere else. She just gets over-exuberant in regard to her behavior when she's engaging with the target and interacting with it. After all that drama with the Colubrids, I have to finish up this Training Tuesday with one of our pythons. This is Tau Ceti. He's a super dwarf reticulated python from Reach Out Reptiles. And I'm asking him to come up to the level where the lower half of his body is. The front half of his body is on the level below. And I'm asking him to do something that's physically possible for him, but that's a little bit hard. And he looks at me a couple of times like, I can't believe you're actually going to make me do this. And I prompt him with the target to tell him, yes, you can do this. Yes, I want you to do this. No, you can't have the reinforcement until you approach and touch the target. So he finally does that for me. And he's getting a small reinforcement this time because it's already his third repetition. And he's had two other food items, and the first one was quite large. Everybody, thank you so much for watching and joining me this evening for another Training Tuesday. I hope that you enjoyed that and that it was helpful to you and your snakes at home. Please remember to always be kind and love your animals. And tune in next week for another episode of Training Tuesday.